what is the scale? You see, the Satchitananda should become more and more. That is the scale, whether you are growing or not. Sat means the clarity. Chit means being aware that you are clear. Ananda means enjoying that you are clear. If you are getting more and more Satchitananda, means you are becoming more clear, more aware, more blissful, then continue. This is the right path. If that is not happening, then something is wrong. If everybody, everyone is enlightened or awakened, how will the creation happen? Which includes the prema and kama, the very natural phenomenon. God is not dependent on you to run the world. Don't worry. He is surely more intelligent to run his creation. And before you took birth, it's not that world was not running. And after you die, don't think world will disappear. So, whoever has put the question, be very clear. God is independently intelligent to create and run, maintain, without your direct help. So, you better get enlightened. That will be the real help you will be doing for creation. Everybody comes and tells me, asks me, if everybody becomes Swami like you, how will the creation happen? Our world is not suffering because there is nobody to reproduce. There is too much of reproduction. Come on, next 10 years, stop reproduction. It is not even 1% of the population has become Swamis. And people have started worrying. As if from tomorrow the whole world is going to stop. Everything is going to come to end. Don't understand, oh God. Actually, I personally feel we should all decide that already we have 620 crore people in the planet Earth. Let's all decide till we provide food, clothes, shelter and medical care for the 620 crore people, we should not bring any more people to the planet Earth. Now, that should be the right decision. So already we have 620 crore here. Come on. Let's provide food, clothes, shelter and medical care for these 620 crore. Then bring more and more. Neither we do this, nor we stop bringing more. One guy came to me in Kalpataru and he said, Swamiji, I am suffering with poverty, please do something. I said, let me know the reason, then I'll try to help. Tell me the reason. He said, I have 14 kids. Said, 14, God. And anyhow, I asked, two itself too much in this society. Why did you give birth 14? He says, no, God gave. No, he doesn't have any shame or guilt or no problem. He's straight away looking into my eyes and saying, God gave. I told him, I can help you about the future, not to have more poverty, but I can't do anything about the past. He said, at least give me some suggestions, Swamiji. I said, get a television set in your house. He said, why? Let you have some other entertainment. So whoever has put that question, please understand. Please quickly get enlightened. We need to stop reproduction. At least in India, I think we should seriously consider. And I think within next 5 years, we are going to cross China as per the survey reports. But recently, I was studying some reports. India's population is no more India's weakness, it seems. Because earlier, we were 100 crore beggars, now we are 100 crore consumers, huge market. There is some advantage. But even then, don't start. It's good if you reduce. In your presence, meditation is being done 100% and experience is very, very wonderful. But if we do it at home, something is missing. Whatever is said and done, Master's presence does play its own role. But don't stop. Because you don't have the physical presence, you don't have to stop. Maybe once that strong vidarka gets established, you see, kudarka means negative reasoning. Darka means reasoning. Darka means reasoning. Kudarka means negative reasoning. Constantly criticizing, trying to find some reason. And vidarka means right reasoning. The right reasoning happens, the right connection happens. You may not need physical presence, but till then this missing will be there. Try to work on right reasoning. That is the only way to solve this problem. No other method. Swamiji, can we have more than one guru? Is it possible to see same divinity in all the gurus? Yes, you can have more than one guru. Please be very clear. Wherever you can, learn from all the sources. Like I always tell people, go to all gardens and pluck beautiful flowers and make a garland for you. Don't miss. And your ego is not that simple. It will die by one guru. It need to learn the lesson from all possible sources. So don't miss. I always tell at least my disciples, go to all gardens and pluck flowers, make a beautiful garland for you. Learn from all possible sources. Don't miss it. After all masters are here to enrich you. All of them are here to enrich you. That is the purpose. So learn from all possible sources and enrich yourself. Make your life blissful. That's all is the only thing. It's not like a shop. If you come to this shop, don't go to that shop. You can learn from all the sources. At least I tell my disciples, don't go to people who say don't go to others. That's all. Don't go to the people who say don't go to others. Otherwise, go to every source and learn from every source. After all, it's all about enriching you. Swamiji is doing pilgrimage to holy places, a process of cleansing. Surely, of late, after this so-called modern-day spiritual ideas have come, this pilgrimage and all has lost its value. Means people are not doing it. I tell you, it really does something inside you. It's not just ritual. If you spend little time going around to the places without criticizing those places, just if you go to Varanasi, don't criticize the Ganga is dirty. What to do? 3 lakh people are landing every day. 3 lakh people are landing. These guys, they go on complaining, comparing with the Western countries and the different religious pilgrimage places. Arey, nobody goes there. Naturally, it will be clean. Arey, come on, Varanasi will be dirty. What to do? Per day, 3 lakh people are landing. 3 lakh people are taking bath only in Varanasi. 3 lakh is floating population. How can any city handle 3 lakh population? So it will be little dirty. Don't curse. Stop cursing, stop criticizing. And see the divinity behind. See our strength. How even from villages people come there by walk. See the positive side. See the largest gathering of human beings is Kumbh Mela. Even last Kumbh Mela I went, 91 million people gathered. Means 9 crore. The whole gathering was managed just by 7,000 policemen. Just 7,000 policemen. If all the pilgrims spit that in that flood, they will all be disappear. They will all disappear. No, just see what I am saying. No, if you are traveling to all other outside India, then you will understand. For 91 million people, how many millions of policemen they need to control. And the beautiful thing is, not a single murder in that whole 42 days, not a single crime, all very petty crime. Somebody stole 10 rupee, 20 rupee, that is okay, what is there? Nothing else. Such huge gathering happening so peacefully, you can see only in India, be very clear. Only in India. And another funny thing, that city doesn't have an operating airport. But Allahabad doesn't have an operating airport. Only army uses that airport. Public can't use. 91 million people, world's largest gathering of human beings, is happening in a city which doesn't have an airport. And usually that city can accommodate only 2 million. means 20 lakh is the maximum possibility, the food and accommodation. But 90 million people come, they all eat, stay, take bath, disperse peacefully and beautifully. Understand? Look at the positive side. If you look at the positive side, everything will become inspiration. Everything will become inspiration. You understand? India has 10 million, 1 crore living temples and monasteries which are visited every day by people. Every day. So look at the positive side. Use all these things. It will all really help. I always tell people, do not leave our lifestyle. Do not leave our lifestyle. It really has value. It really has value. Am I connected to you from earlier lives too? If you are connected now, you are connected eternally. If you are not connected now, then don't bother. Forget about it. Why always sincere and honest people suffer and evil people enjoy life the most? It is not true, ma. It is not true because we need to define enjoyment. In this question, we need to define the honest people and evil people, enjoyment, suffering. All these four words needs clear new definition. Please be very clear. Honest people does not mean they know the science of enjoyment. See, they may be honest. Honest means sometimes, like even dumb guys are honest. See, many times you take dumbness as honesty, tamas as sattva. You take ignorance as innocence. No. Ignorance is not innocence. Tamas is not sattva. Dumbness is not honesty. Ability to live in this life and ability to keep yourself blissful is what I call honesty. So all these words need to be redefined. And moreover, you always have an idea, just because you are suffering, you are always right and a good person. And your enemy, just because he is enjoying, is a bad person. No, it is not. If you look inside, and one more thing, you need to understand one more thing. This question has to be understood from different angles. Just because somebody is living in a big bungalow, you can't say he is living happily. And just because somebody is living in a slum, you can't say he is suffering. And the same way, just because he is rich, if somebody is rich, immediately we give him the title, he is a bad guy. It is not. He must have earned. He must have worked for it. He must have done many things for it. So all these four words, honest people, suffering, evil people, enjoying, all the four words needs clear definition. If you look in, Dharma is still alive. Please understand. The words of Krishna has no expiry date. Dharma is still alive. I personally feel, from my experience, I'm traveling all over the world, seeing all different peoples, culture, nations and everything. I really feel still the world is running perfectly as it should be. You may think I am practical, you may think I am impractical, I do not know about it, but I feel things are as it should be. I have no word against the world and God. I have no negative word against the existence. If any of you think that you will do a better job, I'll tell him next time to give you the chance of creating the world. I feel I can't do a better job than him. He is doing his job perfectly. So if there is some problem inside us, we go on blaming him. So if you stop using God as a dustbin, putting all our dust, if you look, you will really understand everything is happening as it should be. I feel the whole cosmos is auspiciousness overflowing in auspiciousness. Is there life after death? Yes. It's from my experience. There is life after death. There is the reincarnation theory described in the Upanishads is true. Are we all in control of our own lives? Or is it all destiny? It's a beautiful question. See, if I am standing with two legs, I have full freedom to raise right leg or left leg or just stand. But if I have done the one action of lifting the right leg, now I don't have freedom to lift the left leg. Understand? As long as you have not done any action, you have full freedom. If you have done any, if you have done some action, the bondage which is created to you by your own action is destiny. The bondage created to you by your own action is destiny. So you can always undo and restart again. The ability to action of undoing and restarting again is what I call unclutching. Undoing and restarting again. This clarity, if you have, you have jnana. If you are able to live this truth, you are jivan mukta. That's all. That's the essence of everything. So now the whole problem about this, our will and destiny will be solved if you understand this one truth. Can we be forgiven for our negative karmas that haunt us all the time? There is nobody is there to forgive you. Don't bother. You just forgive yourself. That's all. There is nobody sitting there up, taking accounts like Chitragupta. Don't bother. See, the Chitragupta is nothing but your own inner conscience. Your own inner conscience. Just you forgive yourself, you will be relieved. Don't bother. Do not carry, see actually the what you did is not sin. What you are carrying is sin. What you are carrying is sin. I am not saying go and do whatever you want. I am not giving you license or I am not giving you freedom to what you want. All I am saying is understand these basic truths. Do not suffer. There are many things for which you are thinking that you are going to suffer. Does not even get recorded. Doesn't even get recorded. So don't bother about the so-called papa punya and all that. All I see, only one thing gets recorded in the cosmos. That is violence. Only violence gets recorded. The suffering of others. Whatever you cause, the suffering for others, only that gets recorded. Nothing else gets recorded. So don't do that. That's all. Don't do that. And do not suffer. Even if you torture yourself, it's a violence. Don't suffer. Don't bother too much about what will happen, these, that. Do not bother. There is no 42, 52 hells and heavens, different departments for different sins. And the moment you go, you will be burnt, boiled. Don't bother. There is no, the hell and heaven are not physical. They are psychological. They are psychological. Hell and heaven are not geographical. They are psychological. You forgive yourself. That's more than enough.